Kenyans have written to the Chief of Defense Forces, Kahiri, urging him to protect them from police brutality during Nane Nane March. The military has been very friendly with the protesters in the previous, if you recall. And here is the writing coming from demonstration from the Gen Z, a letter which they have written to Mr. Kahiri. Tuesday, August 6, 2024, Mr. Charles Muhiri Kahiri, CBS, Chief of Defense Forces, Ulinzi House, Lennox Road, P.O. Box 40668. Dear CDF Kahiri, protection from police brutality during the Nane Nane March. Dear sir, we write to you with a lot of pain. Rogue Kenyan police officers have been abducting, torturing, brutalizing, and coercively and aimlessly killing us while we have turned to remain, as peaceful as we can during our protest. So far, 60 brave young Kenyans have been killed, while there are hundreds missing. As you are aware, we'll be peaceable and unarmed protesting within Nairobi CBD and other parts of the country on 8th 2024. The reason for our peaceful demonstration is to end corruption, unemployment, especially to youths, incompetent, among other issues. Demonstration is a constitutional right enshrined in Article 37 of 2010 Constitution. We therefore humbly request you to protect us from killings and abduction by police officers have been using live bullet and tear gas on peaceful protesters in contempt of a court order that prohibited them to use such method while dealing with us. We thank you for your friendly and cordial interaction with us during our previous protest, and commend you to maintain that level of professionalism. Then signature is unknown. Concerned citizen, Jeshi Nilet. Fearless, tribeless, and hashtag Nane Nane the star. Where? Storm in paradise. Storm in paradise. As they are writing this letter, I've actually analyzed the police commander team. They have issued a press briefing that they are ready for the demonstration. That is what they have come up with. Gen Z wanaandika pande ingine. Police commanders are also on their neck. Our country is not good at all. We are not at peace as Kenyans. The devil which have turned this country into chaos. We politicians, we must now go to church and pray. Because it is getting too much. I want us to break this into political discussion and come up with one or two, three reasons. Why are the Gen Z writing a letter to Kahiri? And What is the great impact on that demonstration? And why do you think police officers are now on their neck? Before I carry on, ladies and gentlemen, it is still Zion Kenya TV YouTube channel. I appreciate you so much for your support in this broadcast. I want to say feel welcome and give this video a thumb of like. Share it to your friends, family, and relatives. If you've never subscribed to this YouTube platform, take a once again, click that notification bell and subscribe. In that next time, when I upload to such kind of a video, the video will automatically comes into your YouTube platform. And to the members, I want to appreciate you and continue with the same spirit. Let's proceed with this political discussion. Gen Zs are not tired. They are ready and very ready, very much ready. Ruto and his administration team must now check the way forward. That is what I can conclude from that writing letter. To our police officers, this is the best time for you to even protect Kenyans who are demonstrating, because they are acting on the law. Due to some failures the government have done to them, or have done to the youth in this country. And if kama kuna mambo zingine wanaweza fanya kama serikali, waifanye before nane nane. Because these people are saying that they are going to march. Pande zingine unapata serikali pia wanasema you can't march. So it is vice versa. Kila mtu anakuja na idea, mwingine anakuja na idea. Wanaweza patana? Hapana. Sasa hapo ndio itakuwa hivi. Pap. Vita. Na vita kama iko, you know the result. Loss of life, blood, stealing, this and that might happen. That is what is going to happen. Let us not lie. Let us not lie. Mr. Kahiri, they are on your neck. They give you respect. You are a close associate friend to the president. Talk to that man. Talk to Ruto. To call upon youth. If possible, all youth in this country to state house. Waulize ni nini mnataka? Juu mimi siko na wewe. Mimi nitakuja tu nifanya analysis yangu na niende. I'm just trying to rescue and bring a great impact between the Gen Z and the government. Because it is now still rising up more and more. That is what I'm trying to omit. Because these people are wachoki. Hawa si watu wa Raila. Kama sisi tulienda maandamano. Tukachoka nayo. Them, they don't get tired. They even drink coffee. It's somehow interesting, but sad. It's very sad. Give these people job, Your Excellency. Wachana kupeana hao wengine kazi. When you are on a 595 million, I keep advising you. Don't give them. Watch out, wapumzike bwana. Pay our my youth kazi. Wamelaki job. It's simple. Kazi rahisi sana. It's something hata mimi ningekuwa rais ningeona yenyewe. These people, what they disturb me with is majorly job. Hakuna kitu ingine. Jenga viwanda. Jenga viwanda Umabei, jenga viwanda Central, jenga viwanda Kisumu, jenga viwanda sehemu kote nchini. On doing that, you will be on a good move. Let them to bring skill. Wengine weke manager, wengine weke hivi na hivi. Mambo itakuwa sawa. Lakini if you will keep on working those who are well off, mtu akona 1 billion, mtu akona 200 million, 10 billion, bado unampea kazi. Well and fine. I wash my hand. That is what is happening. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much. May God bless you for your great support in this platform.